As of August 21st, 2022, there are 48 volcanoes actively erupting on the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is Ebeko in Russia, which is located on one of the Kuril Islands. Ebeko has several fairly large volcanic craters which have frequently been the site of small to medium-sized explosive eruptions such as seen in this photo. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In the Philippines, satellite data suggests that two volcanoes, Bulusan and Mayon, may be showing signs of unrest through a possible magmatic uplift signature. Meanwhile, in Chile, a suspicious hybrid earthquake was observed at a volcano with a large caldera, Mount Hudson. And in American Samoa, two volcanoes are showing signs of unrest through a series of earthquakes with a likely magmatic signature. As a result, the alert level was raised at both Tau and Ufu-Ulusega from white, indicating a lack of thorough monitoring equipment, to yellow, indicating overall increased activity. The reason why two volcanoes have their alert level raised rather than one is owed in part due to the uncertainty of exactly where the earthquakes are originating. This is because before this week, the three islands which have an overall population of about 1,100 did not have any active monitoring stations. Two were put in place during the latest unrest, presenting data that suggests the earthquakes caused by the movement of magma are originating somewhere beneath the island of Tau rather than close to Ufu-Ulusega or a submarine seamount to the east. These earthquake storms have been ongoing since July 26th of 2022, involving many hundreds of earthquakes, the largest of which were in the magnitude 2 to 3 range. During some hours, 20 earthquakes are being recorded, although most are too small to feel. While the exact age of several vents on the three islands is unclear, what is clear is that both volcanoes have produced eruptions in the Holocene, indicating the last 11,700 years. Ufu-Ulusega produced at least one explosive tuff ring-forming eruption during this time period and a submarine explosive eruption just offshore of its landmass in 1866. On the other hand, the exact age of recent eruptions on Tau is unclear, but several spatter cones, cinder cones, and tuff cones can be found on its flanks. These vents are generally aligned on two chains of activity, suggesting that if an eruption was to occur, these areas would represent the most likely spot for one to begin. Although the ongoing seismic activity is highly unusual, the vast majority of times a magmatic intrusion does not result in a new volcanic eruption. In the Philippines, the Bulusan volcano has been in a raised alert level since June 5th of this year when an unexpected phreatic eruption occurred. After a second phreatic eruption a week later, this volcano remained at a heightened state of unrest with high levels of sulfur dioxide gas emissions, but has not produced another eruption. However, a recent satellite InSAR dataset suggests the magmatic uplift is still ongoing at this volcano. Despite the noise in this map due in part to thick vegetation and frequent rainfall, Bulusan clearly shows up as a high point. Additionally, there is another potential magmatic uplift signature to the north at the Mayon volcano which has not erupted since 2019. Although this uplift signal is stronger than the confirmed one at Bulusan, I have been unable to independently verify from Phivolcs that is a true signal. In southern Chile is one of the most explosive active volcanoes in all of South America. There, the Mount Hudson volcano has repeatedly produced plenty of eruptions in the last 10,000 years, with at least three eruptions being larger than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Its last major eruption occurred in 1991. It was assigned a volcanic explosivity index of a 5. Thus, whenever any sort of activity occurs at this volcano, it is closely monitored. An unusual volcanic quake known as a hybrid earthquake struck the volcano on August 14th at around 4:30 local time. While seemingly an isolated event, hybrid earthquakes originate due to the movement and residence of fluids within the volcano's conduits. In other words, a small change may have occurred in its hydrothermal system. While suspicious, this quake was not all that unordinary. A similar event also occurred on March 7th of 2022, and that did not result in a volcanic eruption. Thus, its alert level remains at green. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Jessica Deason for supporting this channel.